So this is sick as fuck. I don't understand. So many people, thank you all so much for coming to be a part of this. It means the world to us. Another thing that we sort of take very, very seriously, and that would mean the world to us, if we just look out for each other, everyone here, be respectful of the person next to you. I want everyone to feel invited to come in here, scream these words, get loose with us, not just a particular aggressive type. Bane is for everyone, so come on in. You will be looked out for. That's it. This is a dancing song, and we want you to go crazy.
I'm about to die. Zero.
We're called Bang. You fuck with it? Yeah, I wrote that song a long time ago. And I can't really speak on what starting again means to any of you. We all had different entry points into this. We all have different nostalgias that we hold on to as particularly special or magical. I wrote that song at a time where a lot of the kids I was hanging around with, going to shows with, seemed really preoccupied with being cool, with dressing a certain way, looking a certain fucking way. I would hear them talk shit about other people, and it just was such a triggering reminder of why I found punk rock to begin with, to escape all of that circus, backbiting, petty bullshit. I will believe to my grave that this shit is for the fucking freaks and the weirdos and the people that never want to fucking fit in. For me, that's what Can We Start Again is about. It's about coming in here and being exactly who you fucking want to be without any fear about some fuck judging you from afar. We haven't played this online in maybe 9 years. Wish us luck.
Why give a fuck? That's all.
Than you think you can. Let's thank these bands. What a bill. Hold My Own, Give It Up. So sick. Dudes late in life, starting their fucking hardcore band, crawling back in the van. Because they can't let go. Because this thing is in their bloodstream. They don't give a fuck about what it means to start over. Or what it means to have a better job or some fucking bullshit. Give it up for Hold My Own. Incredible. Inspiring. Haywire! Boston Hardcore! Put some respect on that. One of my favorite people in the world. Trumps that band, and I'm so excited to see what they're out here doing, what they're becoming. It's truly special. Cro-Mags, New York City, Age of Quarrel, Chappelle. You don't get to share a lot of stages with someone who absolutely directly just rooted right to this band who changed my life. Made a record that impacted me so greatly that I took a veered off the fork and never came back. Thank you to Harley and his band. Stick to your guns, give it up! An almighty terror. What a set that was. Probably the hardest band to have to go on stage after. I don't envy us at all anytime we've ever had to do it. But we love them so much, we just keep putting ourselves in that position. We've been doing it for, I don't know, 15 years. Thank you to them for being a part of this. I know they're coming to the end of the run. Gonna do a couple more with us, and then we're gonna say goodbyes. Why do you keep saying play cover? So weird. Do you know where you are? Where you want us to play?
Every rose has its thorn.
Play cover. You might have wandered into the wrong room.
Thank you.
you so much to everyone who worked hard to make this show happen. This isn't just one person. It's a collective effort to put together something of this magnitude. We want to thank all involved, all the staff here have been incredibly respectful, cool, do whatever we want as long as we're being respectful and cool. That's all we ever ask for. Thank you, everyone here. Yeah, boy. You're like, you're clear for it. So one of the things I respect more than anything else in this life is when a person decides that they're not gonna chase that fucking carrot on the end of a stick anymore. They're gonna find a different way to have to fucking make ends meet, make their rent, put food in the mouths of them and their loved one. They just cannot continue to be a part of this rat race. So they find one hustle or 10 hustles and they do it their fucking way. And I'm so pleased to live in an era where that has become more common, where a little bit of creativity and grit and fucking grind can get you out of that horrible, soul-deadening rat race. Y'all live in New York City, so I don't know if anyone relates. I think maybe everyone's fucking out there struggling. Thank you. birthday, Stanley. Us back the way you have. Anyone who's been at one or more than one band shows in the last 2 years who have made us feel so welcome and sort of made the tough decision to begin playing shows again feel a little bit more obvious. It's something we really wrestled with. I know that we had said a lot of things for a lot of people in those 2 years when we were putting out Going Up and saying goodbye to all these places. And we love you too. And that's just sort of the whole point. Tonight, seeing so many friends, so many faces who we haven't seen in a very, very long time, is sort of, and to me, it's everything. To me, it's the thing that I miss the most. More than this, the stage dives, the singing, the accolades. It's that connection with people that you make on tour that doesn't follow you home when you take yourself off the road. So to see so many friends and loved ones here tonight, the best. I really, really thank you. This last song is going to be dedicated to you guys. People who've been with us a long time. There's people in this room who saw us at fucking CBGB's in the year 2000. Your love and support is everything. We'll see you again. I will not care.